In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient...
For our Goodnight message on this Friday, the 2nd of September 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian community of the Sacred Heart, Makene, Lusaka, Zambia, by your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message entitled Principles of Spiritual Warfare. I don't know about you, but I speak for myself. I have fought spiritual battles a number of times. I don't know about you, but I have often fought spiritual warfare. And if I asked you a question, have you ever engaged in spiritual warfare? And your answer is a hard no, you need to think again. The truth is, spiritual warfare is something we all experience, and it happens more often than you think. Spiritual warfare involves both everyday life and otherworldly battles. Theologians have historically described it in terms of three arenas: the world, the flesh, and the devil. This framework comes from Paul's letter to the Ephesians in chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. They know that small victories can lead to major destruction. Paul gives an example. The first thing we have to know is that spiritual warfare uses footholds to establish strongholds. According to the Oxford Dictionary, a foothold is a secure position from which further progress may be made. Satan and his demons do everything they can to establish these footholds, and they are more patient than you think. They know that small victories can lead to major destruction. Paul gives an example. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 26 to 27 says, "And don't sin by letting anger control you. Don't let the sun go down while you are still angry, for anger gives a foothold to the devil." The devil knows that a foothold of anger can turn into a stronghold of bitterness and resentment. Oxford defines a stronghold as a place that has been fortified so as to protect it against attack. Footholds are about gaining ground, and they are used when we are on the offensive. Strongholds are about protecting ground already taken, a defensive position. If you are not alert to the footholds that the enemy wants to establish, you will be prone to allowing him to establish strongholds that are much harder to tear down. But this principle works both ways in spiritual warfare. As Christians, we can work to establish good footholds in our lives through spiritual disciplines such as prayer and Bible study. Those footholds lead to defensive strongholds from which we experience spiritual victory. But what do these footholds look like? How can we stay on the lookout? Spiritual warfare is a battle waged most often in our minds. While the heavenly realm exists, a place with angels and demons and even Satan himself, it is a mistake to think that spiritual battles are exclusively fought there. A close reading of the Bible tells a different story. That spiritual warfare is waged in the thought realm more than anywhere else. Paul explained it like this to the church in Corinth. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3 to 5. We are human, but we don't wage war as humans do. We use God's mighty weapons, not worldly weapons, to knock down the strongholds of human reasoning and to destroy false arguments. We destroy every proud obstacle that keeps people from knowing God. We capture their rebellious thoughts and teach them to obey Christ. Human reasoning, false arguments, and rebellious thoughts, these are all weapons that are used against our minds. Spiritual warfare is a battle for our beliefs, memories, insecurities, fears, and fantasies. Satan uses bad ideas to establish a foothold in our lives. And he's been doing it since the beginning of time. Genesis chapter 3 verse 1 to 6. Remember that story of how Eve found herself in a trap? It was the mind. Eve was not just talking to a snake out there. It was in her mind. Train your mind well, and the word of God will help you do that. And prayer will help you do that, to fight the spiritual battles in your life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.